It's Hassan from HTFX, and I wanted to make a small video about Link. This pattern is a classic a move end, which is something in here. So let's do this. This triangle ended something, probably somewhere around here with a B to D trend line, something like this. And now what we are left with is, it looks like a zigzag pattern. So what you should do is fairly simple. You put wave A here, wave B does look like ended somewhere like this with another triangle pattern formation. Okay, so now what you need is you have to check the time taking for wave A. I'm sorry, I took the wrong one. And then you copy it to this B. As you can see, the price is rejecting from where it should. So now you have to determine, I don't know, sorry, why I'm making this much mistakes today. So what you have to do is fairly simple. Now that we have an ABC, we have to understand if we could end this wave, let's say A here, on a bigger degree here, or whatever this is actually, cannot, it doesn't have to be wave A, but it does look like a wave A because it just started something. Can it end here, or can it end somewhere on the right side? To be understand this, we have to understand if this wave A with white ABC, this zigzag pattern, is a simple pattern or no, or complex pattern. So what we do is this, to draw 0 to B trend line, and take this time, put it here, and put it on the right side. Now we wait. What we wait? If the price does come in time to the and break 0 to B trend line and come all the way to here, then after the price is here, we can put wave A here. Okay? Not before. Not before. No. Now, if the time is up and the price doesn't do it, and the price is doing something like this, for example, or it can even do something like this, it can go to wave B, but not in the time. So it means that whatever we have is here will be an X wave. Now, by the way, price after here can roll over, make a new low. It means that this X wave is here. Now we have to understand this possibility. Now that as of now, we don't know we have an X wave or no. Why? Because the market still has time to actually come here. So this is the labelings that should be on the right side now. Okay, and now you have to wait. Now, after markets are giving us more clue, then we can understand if this is a complex correction, then what we understand, we need to know what kind of X wave we have. Large X wave or a small X wave. For example, if I'm dealing with a large X wave, what I have to do, first of all, it doesn't matter if it's small or large, but let me show it to you. So let's say that this is really the C wave ended here. Okay, now what I need to do, I need to take a Fibonacci level from the start to the end. And I will check this 618 level. And interestingly, this 618 level comes exactly to B wave. So if this X wave comes here, of course, if it fails to do it in the time as required, and comes something like this or ends here, then I will say, okay, I have a correction with a large X wave. If I have a correction with a large X wave, what does it mean? I have different possibilities, such as double three combination, triple three combination. But what if I have an X wave that's ended here? Well, it means, or even here, or somewhere here, then it means I have different possibilities, such as I have possibilities such as double zigzag, triple zigzag. We cannot have a flat because the first correction of zigzag, so we can have a double combination or a triple combination. Now, of course, this is the corrective approach. If this move is actually impulsive, well, we have a problem. What's the problem is, first of all, this move does look like a triangle, but maybe in lower degree, it is something like a double combination that ends with a triangle. If it is, then we can put a wave 2 here, okay? And we could have put wave 1 here if it's really an impulsive move. If you're trading an impulsive move, then what do I do? What do I do if I'm, for example, wrong? It does look to me corrective, but let's say if it's impulsive too, then what do? I take my first wave, okay, and I take my fib level and I try to get 106.18, okay. Then I put it right here and I put it where this two wave is, and I will say, okay, this price should go here minimum. Okay, now does this mean you should go short now if you think that it's impulsive? Well, I would not, because what I would wait here is to understand if I want to trade this. For me, there are so much risks because this move does to me look more like a zigzag. So if I want to take this impulsive way approach to the downside, it means that I have to neglect this corrective move and all of its possibilities too. Then it is, we don't know enough to, the price didn't do enough for me to prove to me that this is actually a impulsive move. So this is why I should, for example, if I was trading it, by the way, I am not trading this, but if I wanted to trade it, what I would have wanted to see is more from the market to prove to me that yes, we are in an impulsive move, okay? But for me, I'm leaning towards more to the corrective side as of this moment, okay? After this corrective move, is after this X wave, then we have different possibilities, like I said, and then this wave is done. Now, after this wave is done, let's say that after this X wave, we have a triangular formation, then this A wave is done. Well, we need to go wherever this wave A ends, 618, because this was the corrective move. Because it means that whatever we are dealing with is should be a flat, because the first move are, unless this is actually a corrective of something before here, and it is a triangle. But usually in these situations, it's the flat. So whatever after this wave A is done, can be here, it can be here, I don't know where it can be done, but after it is done, we need 618 to come. Okay, thank you so much guys, and see you in the next one.